It's Tuesday, June 23rd here in Seoul. I'm Jessica from Korea Now, and these are your daily headlines.
The office of President Moon Jae-in on Monday strongly criticized former White House National Security Advisor John Bolton for his distorted claims in his memoir, which was initially scheduled to be published on June 23rd. Jung Hee-yong, director of national security at Chungwade, said former advisor John Bolton describes negotiations between the leaders of Korea, the U.S. and North Korea, and related situations from his point of view. The memoir does not reflect accurate facts. Also, the truth is seriously distorted in large parts. He added that it could harm the sincerity of future negotiations very seriously and expressed hope the U.S. government would take an appropriate measure to prevent such a dangerous case from recurring. Meanwhile, the White House has requested that over 400 parts of John Bolton's upcoming memoir to be revised or deleted, of which 110 parts were from Korean Peninsula-related issues. U.S. President Donald Trump also criticized Bolton on his Twitter, calling him grossly incompetent and a liar. North Korea is reinstalling propaganda loudspeakers in regions along the inner Korean border after removing them under a joint summit agreement with South Korea. An official of the Joint Chief of Staff said such moves are spotted in more than 10 regions which have taken place simultaneously. The North has been detected setting up loudspeakers again in multiple places inside the DMZ from around Sunday. It had dismantled dozens of loudspeakers in around 40 areas near the tense border in a first action to follow up on the Panmunjom Declaration. South Korea, in response, is also reviewing the option of bringing back its loudspeakers. The North State Media reported Monday that it is preparing to send around 12 million anti-Seoul propaganda leaflets as a retaliatory punishment. K-Contact 2020 Summer, the online Korean cultural festival held by CJENM, has kicked off on Saturday. The 7-day concert includes live concerts, live meet-and-greet session, and one-on-one video call interview involving the latest VR and AR technology to bring fans closer to their favorite stars. On the first day of its concert, Monsta X, Luna, The Boys, and Kim Jae-hwan were featured, drawing global fans from 139 countries. Monsta X performed its title song Fantasia on a magnificent VR stage on desert with AR effects of sand breeze. There was also a virtual sing-along session with the fans. After the concert, the member Minhyuk said, "Since the fans were sitting in front of the screen, it felt like we're performing together."
Those are your top stories for today. For full-length articles, you can always check out our official website linked down below. And don't forget to subscribe to Korea Now for more daily updates.